Hey, this is the third in a connected set of lectures regarding dynamic programming solution for the weighted interval scheduling problem. And I have copied my set of intervals and relevant information right up here from the previous lectures. You can see I have 8 intervals. I'm not specifying the start time and finish time of these intervals, but I have as much information as I need about that here in this row labeled pizza by. What this 3 right here means is that for interval number 6, interval number 3 is the interval that precedes 6 and does not overlap 6 and is the rightmost of a set of intervals preceding 6. So altogether, I would have intervals preceding 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Those are all preceding 6 because this is sorted in order. And the overlapping intervals we saw previously were 4 and 5. The intervals that are left that don't overlap would be 1, 2, and 3. And 3 would be the rightmost of those. So that's this 3 right here. I have also copied down the value or the weights of each of these intervals, and just to keep things really uncluttered, I've just used the interval number as the weight value. So that's going to require some addition, but we'll do the best we can here. Now here is my dynamic programming solution right here. And you can see a couple things in this solution. First of all, I am recording in an array the values that I'm computing. In this case, I'm going forward from J, which is my set of intervals that I'm considering, from the set that only has 1, to the set that has 1 and 2, to the set that has 1, 2, and 3, and so on up to the set that has 1, 2, 3, dot, 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 up to N, all those intervals. And you see I'm computing my M of J, and the formula that I'm using is the same as what I had before. I had either my jth interval is being considered as a part of the optimal, which in case I include the value for that interval, plus the value that's already been computed for the subset, for the set of intervals that precede that J that don't overlap, right? So that this M of P would refer to all the intervals that precede that J and don't overlap with J. And this M of P of J is the already computed answer. So either my optimal solution will have this value or it will have this value. This is the already computed value of the optimal solution for all the intervals where J is not a part of the solution. So if I'm considering interval J, either J will be in the solution or it will be not in the solution. If J is in the solution, this is the number we store in our M array. If it is not in the solution, this is the number we store in our M array. Okay, so let us go ahead and start to compute our M array right here. So we'll label the indexes up here as best I can. Okay, and then we'll work on values. Okay, so So for M of 0, we initialize at 0 right here. Okay, now we do for J equals 1 up to whatever. So M of 1 is going to be the max of the weight of 1, the weight of 1 is 1, plus the M of P of 1, P of 1 is 0, so the M of 0 is 0, or the M of 1 minus 1 is 0. Okay, and we know that right here the M of 0 is 0. So obviously the solution here is 1 is the max of these two values. Okay, so what's being said here is that if I only consider the set of intervals that have just 1 in it, then my optimal solution will have a value of 1. Okay, so let's look at J equals 2, so this is J is 1. Here, let's do J equals 2. Okay, so I need to compute the max of V of J, so that's V of 2 is 2, plus M of P of J. P of 2 is 0, so M of 0 is 0, or the m of 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1 is 1, so the m of that is 1. Okay, so that will give me a value of 2. And what's being said right here is if I have the set of intervals 1 and 2, and I'm looking for the maximum value for the weighted interval scheduling program, so there's no overlap allowed, then I will have a value of 2. Okay, j is 3, so I'll be computing the max of v of 3 is 3 plus m of p of 3. P of 3 is 1, so m of 1 is 1, or m of 3 minus 1 gives me m of 2. M of 2 is 2. So I'm looking at 4 or 2, so that would give me 4. Okay, then j equals 4, max of, v of 4 is 4, plus m of p of 4. P of 4 is 2, so m of 2 gives me 2, or m of 4 minus 1 is m of 3. M of 3 gives me 4. So the max value there is 6. Okay, for j equals 5, I'm looking for the max of v of 5, which is 5, plus m of p of 5. P of 5 is 4. M of 4 is 6. Right? Here's m of 4. There's m of 4 value is 6, or m of 5 minus 1, that's m of 4, which I've already seen is 6. So that will give me 11. Okay, for j is 6, I'll be computing the max of the value for interval 6, which is 6, plus m of p of 6. P of 6 is 3, m of 3 is 4, or m of 6 minus 1, that's m of 5, is 11. So 10 or 11, the max of those two is 11. And we can see that I will not be including interval 6 in the optimal solution to the problem of considering the intervals between 1 and 6. 7. So I need to compute the max of value for interval 7 plus m of p of 7. M of p of 7. P of 7 is 1. M of 1 is 1. Or m of 7 minus 1, that's m of 6, is 11. So that gives me 11. Okay, and 8. I'll be computing where I include 8, so that's 8 plus m of p of 8. P of 8 is 1. M of 1 is 1. Or m of 8 minus 1, that's m of 7, is 11. So there we go, 11. And if I go back and I look at what my previous interval looks like, let's just take a quick look at my previous pictures right here, we can see that the optimal solution, I've got for 8 will be just the interval, the solution to what I have for 5, and the solution, so if I'm just taking a quick look at that right there, so if I include all these things, then actually what will give me my best solution is 5 plus 4 plus 2. So 5 plus 4 makes 9. 5 right here plus 4 makes 9 plus 2 makes 11. So if I'm considering all this set of intervals 1 through 8, my optimal set will have 5, 4, and 2 in it.